Sweet. All right. Kia ora, everybody. Welcome to room two, not room one. We're talking about cyber. That's how it's not a noun. Apparently, according to the bees, I'm going to be ranting at you today. And so I am Creature. I'm a policy and I'm a geopolitics and national security nerd. I'm a tech enthusiast. I'm that annoying coordinated disclosure person. So if you ever want to talk about someone about how to go about disclosing sweet bugs you found in something, you can come talk to me. Also for a day job, I do policy and advocacy for Internet NZ, which is why I'm wearing a t-shirt saying I play keyboard for the internet. I bought it when they gave me the job. I don't have cats. I do have a dog. I figured I'd chuck in a dog picture. Anyway, so I'm ranting at you today, apparently, because words matter. All right, so I'm a word nerd. I'm not a code nerd. I can't computer. I got a presentation to work that's better than the last time I tried to talk at a hackathon. And words matter a lot to me, and I think they matter a lot for communication. And we're going to talk about one word in particular, okay? Which is cyber. Cyber is not a noun. Okay, it's pretty simple. It's just not. So spoiler for the end of the talk, it's an adjective. But hashtag cyber is not a noun. This is a live hashtag on Twitter, and by live I mean it's like 80-90% me replying and ranting at people and saying no, cyber is not a noun. But I think one of the kind of things is, you know, cyber, like when you talk to non-technical people, like cyber's sexy, right? Like people get, oh, cyber, the internet, and the number of people working in this industry is booming, right? And the breadth of people we need, but as I said, I'm a geopolitics and national security nerd, so I spend a lot of time talking to political scientists and academics, and I'm a policy nerd, so policy people, and cyber as a noun comes up, what I would say, way too much, right? People work, I've been in meetings where someone says, I work in cyber, and I've sat there and gone, well, I'm using desktop as a service too, but I don't think that's what you mean, right? Because I think it is a problem, because words matter. And the thing is, everyone wants the cybers, and these days we have everyone working in the cybers, and here's a scary chart written by a political scientist. This is from Joe Nye, who's like a really famous American political scientist. He wrote this for the Global Commission on Internet Governance. So the stuff in the dotted box is actual internet things. And everything else is this broad. All of these organizations that have nothing to do and have never historically done anything with internet or security or cybersecurity, whatever the hell you want to call it, right, are now working in cyber, right? And it's like they are not doing the same thing. Most of them are not doing remotely the same thing. And my main premise, I would say, is that using cyber as a noun makes people think they're talking about the same thing. They're just not. So, like, what is a cyber? I'm sorry, like, it's just not a thing. It means many things, and it means different things, which to me says it's meaningless. Okay? So, great quote from one of my favorite political science strategy authors, Thomas Ridd. Cyber is a chameleon, as he puts it, because it means one thing to someone from Wall Street, it means a totally different thing to an analyst from Israel. It means something very, very different to a Ukrainian banker. And if you're a Brazilian activist, then cyber means something different as well. And then you throw in the diplomats, right? So we're talking about really, really different things. And as Thomas Ridd, he has this great book about, because everyone in our industry is talking about cyber, and he's like, where the hell does this word come from? And actually, it's cybernetics. Okay, so The Rise of the Machine is a brilliant book written by him, and you know, because cyber originally is about how do you get a Lancaster turret gunner to be able to defend you against German fighters? How do an artillery crew actually track a V2 missile coming in and shoot it down before it kills your civilians? That's where cyber comes from, right? And of course, like, you can't do it. Gibson quote, I didn't do Sun Tzu, so I had to do Gibson, right? So like the consensual hallucination for cyberspace. I love it. We'll get back to cyberspace later. And also cyberpunk, like my favorite tabletop role-playing setting. And of course, to cyber, the verb, meant something very different in the late 80s. So if you're in a meeting at work and someone says, oh, we need to cyber that really well, or the cyber's really important, you may see people about my age go, right? And I was trying to think, what's a really good way of summing up why I think this talking past each other thing is a problem? And it's War on the Rocks did it beautifully for me, right? So they're a really cool geopolitical blog, mostly American. They take blogs and essays from people around the world. So, you know, where should the Pentagon's duties begin and end with cyber? Well, like, I don't know. Are you talking about warfare? Are you talking about cyber war? Are you talking about cyber security? Are you talking about defense of critical national infrastructure? You what, mate? Like, I don't know. Some? You know, give them some cyber? All that's really left for me and what cyber means to me is something computery. Okay? Prefix. All right, and this guy, I found this on Twitter. He was actually talking about DevOps, and I was like, oh my God, this fits my thing perfectly. You have terms, and they get used so much that people just start co-opting them and throwing them in front of things so they sound like they know what they're talking about. So for me, like, kind of where does that leave us, right? Something computery by itself is not very useful. And when people talk about the cyber, they risk talking past one another, which in my world, in the policy and national security thinking area, that's kind of bad. So if it's everything, it's anything, then it's nothing, because it's a chameleon. Which comes to the basic premise, as I was saying, it's just not a noun. Okay, cyber is not a noun. It's just not. So fair cop, one acceptable noun-like use: a cyber dialogue. Governments have these. It's a dialogue about cyber, not a dialogue that's computery. They're face to face. There's no Slack or Skype involved. And this is where governments talk to each other about all sorts of things, right? They talk about online identity, digital economy, they talk about all that kind of stuff. How do we do critical national infrastructure, information sharing, threat intelligence, all that stuff. And then they also have a quiet word, especially if you're in a dialogue with China, can you stop hacking my shit? It's a good glow, and they never have to tell the media or anyone else that that's the stuff they're also talking about. So it's kind of useful. I'll give governments that one. For all other situations, I'm really sorry to say, and I'm sure for some of you feel exactly the same way as me on this. Like, if you use cyber as a noun, you're going in this box, right? Like, it's my mental box for people who clearly don't know what they're talking about. They're also the kind of people who talk in the theatre, right? Like I'm sorry, and I know that seems mean, and it's a passag, and yeah, fair cop, it kind of is. I've been thinking about this, and you know, a lot of us are new to the sector, and as I said, you know, like the people that cybersecurity, infosec, computer security, whatever you want to call it, it needs way more people, it needs broader people, it needs different people. And one of the things is the words we use really matter when we're talking to those people and getting them in, and the words that and what they're trying to understand, it's harder when people are using verbal hand wave that is cyber as a noun. Right, so this XKCD, I do actually have attribution, it's just I couldn't figure out how to change my words from white. You know, we all get to learn something new. If you are new and you want to talk to technical people about cybers, then I'll be covering off a bunch of words, useful words, because it's cyber what? It's a totally acceptable adjective. It's a prefix. So cybersecurity. Sorry, Chris isn't here, so I can say that without him like raging. Cyber espionage, that's computer espionage. I can get on board with understanding that. cyberpunk, cyber warfare. You know, they're discrete areas of thinking, and they're discrete areas of things. And so you would have seen, cyberspace wasn't on that list. You know, Creature, what do you think about cyberspace? I'm glad you didn't ask, because I'm not a fan. Okay, I'm not a fan of cyberspace, the term. It's just the internet for me. I mean, cyberspace, as Gibson describes it, you know, that consensual hallucination of operators across everywhere, right? Like, we don't have that yet. I cannot slap on my goggles and jack in and have a sword fight with Hero Protagonist, right? Like, which I would obviously lose because he wrote the sword fighting program. That thing doesn't exist yet, because cyberspace right now, it isn't a space. It's just the internet. It's the things. And this term of cyberspace enables a lot of miscalculation, actually. Like, people kind of, you know, because it's this other place, it's different from in real life. Like, internet's real life, it's just not meat space. And it enables mental laziness. Like, we see this, you know, like, the US Air Force is going to fight and fly in cyberspace. You're sitting at a chair and you're sending packets. You are flying nowhere. Like, I don't care if you're wearing a flight suit or not. You are flying nowhere. You know, and take risks without thinking about these consequences, like hackback. I mean, Jesus. You shouldn't have the right to hackback against people in other countries. Like, you're just not tall enough to be on that ride yet. And it isn't somewhere else, okay? It's right here. It's in the room. It's just the internet protocol. If you ship internet protocol, you're cyberspace. That's just flowery talk for the internet. And I'd much rather talk about the internet, because, you know, I play keyboard for it. Who cares? Like, it's just words. I get it. No. What did I say at the beginning? Words matter. Right? Words matter. And we need good words. In fact, we need the best words. Great words. Because if, the cybers, it's big. Bigly. Look, bad things are going on, right? So, like, last year, 2 billion user creds. You got CIA's toolset walked out the door. You've got the NSA's TAO toolset walked out the door. I don't know if anyone else has been paying attention, but last time I checked, OWASP top 10 web bugs, have they changed? I think this year they squished one in with another to make room. It's been going a while. Things aren't getting better. And as Bogan pointed out this morning, we have influence campaigns all through the internet. The Russians, brief digress on geopolitics. The Russians have this word for deception warfare, maskirovka, and it means both camouflage and full-on psyops and deception warfare. And they are fully integrating the internet into it. They're brilliant at it. I mean, in a world where, you know, North Korea and Russia take shitty commercial ransomware, configure it poorly on purpose, chuck an NSA exploit on the front 9 weeks after it's patched, and still do, like, I think NotPetya ended up doing $1 billion damage to 3 companies. I mean, no one, you know, Merck didn't make Hep B vaccines for 4 weeks. All right, like, this is not some little technical, we got to rebuild a machine, I guess. You know, these countries are having real implications against each other's economies. Things are bad. I know, like, no, it's not fine. It is not fine. And I think we need good solutions for the actual problems, right? If all we're doing, and politicians and the broader discourse, is talking about cyber and the challenges of cyber, we're not actually working on real things. Like, I mean, I want whitelisting that works. I want app whitelisting that's easy to deploy, that isn't horrible and a pain. We can use meaningful words. We can talk about the actual things and the challenges, right? We can use good words or best words. You know, the internet, cybersecurity. I mean, InfoSec, if that's your bag. I like InfoSec. It is subtly, I guess, the Venn diagram doesn't quite map up on computer security or network security all the time. Cyber espionage, I get that. Cyber warfare, not cyber war. I will nerd out at someone over cyber war. Single domain warfare doesn't exist. It was just like in the 30s. Air war, we don't need infantry or navy anymore, we'll just bomb people. That didn't work. Same with internet war. It's a part. All of those things are useful. They're discrete, right? So attack and defense are not exactly the same. The ways in which you deal and go about securing your networks are important when dealing with espionage, but espionage is inherently political. You cannot just do your organizational people process tech, right? It needs more, it needs others. So I guess what I'm saying is, please don't use cyber by itself and call other people on it. Do it in a nice way. Say, hey, you said cyber. Are you talking about cybersecurity or are you talking about espionage? You work in cyber. Are you a networky person? What does that mean? Politely but firmly. I was at a thing earlier this week and there was a panel and someone went cyber. I was like, Twitch. Someone else went cyber. I was like, Twitch. And then someone else went cyber. I was like, I'm really sorry, but can we please not use cyber as a noun? I actually don't know what we're talking about. You just mentioned it in two totally different ways. Let's get a bit more specific. Because words matter. So I was kind of thinking, how can we kind of sum this up? What's a useful way of thinking about this? And I read way too many kids' books, so do not cyber for warplanes. Do not cyber on the mains. Do not cyber during work time. And do not cyber to make a rhyme. I can. Do not cyber space and docks. Do not cyber, it fucking sucks. Okay? Do not cyber here or there. Do not cyber anywhere. Please do not cyber, Sam I am. Because it kind of sounds dumb. And I was like, oh, where can I find a good example of people using this? And I found this great article from Slate. From a while ago, which tangential to basically quite a similar thing, cyber's dumb, don't use it. And I found this great quote from a high school student who was building, their school was building a cyber security club. And she's like, nah, it's not cool. Just call it a computer security club. And that's what it is. Yeah, it sounds like you're trying to be cool, but you're not, because teenagers are smart. So I guess, closing, I thought I'd go at this a pretty full tilt. Cyber is not a noun, it's an adjective, it's a prefix, it needs a buddy to be useful. Okay? Because words matter, and let's use good ones. Okay, so thanks. Thank you to